Good morning and welcome to Bible in a Year. As today we are on day 230, we are going through the Bible, the Holy Bible, from Genesis to Revelations in the New International Version. My name is Pastor Jay Lutz, and today we are tackling the time of exile as we go through the adventure timeline created by Jeff Cavins, where it breaks down the Bible into different regions. And today we're going to be going through Jeremiah 7, Ezekiel 36, Proverbs 14, 29 to 32. And the color is fuchsia. I wear the same colors for the same periods, just so you can tell the different periods apart. So today we're going through these readings. We'll reflect a little bit on them. Jeremiah 7, the Israelites know that they have been chosen by God and that he dwells in the temple. In their pride, they believe that God will remain with them regardless of their actions. In verse 12, the Lord tells the people to go to Shiloh, a place where sacrifices were once offered but no longer are. Here God reminds them that he has removed his presence from a sacred place in the past. In Matthew chapter 16, Jesus proclaims the establishment of his church built upon Peter the rock. Yet many of us who acknowledge the church fail to live faithfully within it. Similarly, in John 6, Jesus makes it clear that communion is his body, blood, soul, and divinity. Though we might receive Jesus in Holy Communion, we still might fail to conform our lives fully to him. In Ezekiel chapters 36, we hear today the advice of following your heart, but our hearts can lead us astray. The first two movements of conversion are distrust of self and trust in the Lord. I don't know what it is good for me, but I can trust God does. False worship often leads to the valley of Hinnom, Gehenna, where people would offer their children as burnt offerings to worship a false god, usually Moloch. This is one of the neighboring nations of Israel. Well, Jeremiah prophesies before the destruction of Jerusalem. Ezekiel preaches after the destruction has occurred. In Ezekiel 36:8, we hear words of hope spoken to a people already in exile, words of hope of return. Through Ezekiel, the Lord proclaims that he will transform the people's hearts of stone into hearts of flesh. And like Ezekiel, the passage today in Solomon, Proverbs 14:29-32, speaks to the heart matters. That those who have a heart of peace find refuge because of their righteousness. They show kindness, which honors God. They give life to their bodies by not harboring envy. And they have great understanding because they are not quick-tempered. So, let's read all about them, starting with Jeremiah chapter 7. Chapter 7. This is the word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord. Stand at the gate of the Lord's house and there proclaim this message. Hear the word of the Lord, all you people of Judah who come through these gates to worship the Lord. This is what the Lord Almighty, the God of Israel, says. Reform your ways and your actions. I will let you live in this place. Do not trust in deceptive words and say, this is the temple, Lord, the temple, Lord, the temple of the Lord. If you really change your ways and your actions and deal with each other justly, if you do not oppress the alien, the fatherless, the widow, and do not shed innocent blood in this place, if you do not follow other gods to your own harm, then I will let you live in this place, in the land I gave your forefathers, forever and ever. But look, you are trusting in deceptive words that are worthless. Will you steal and murder? Commit adultery and perjury, burn incense to Baal and follow other gods you have not known, and then come and stand before me in the house which bears my name and say, we are safe? Safe to do all these detestable things? Has this house which bears my name become a den of robbers to you? But I have been watching, declares the Lord. Go now to the place in Shiloh where I first made a dwelling for my name. And see what I did to it because of the wickedness of my people Israel. While you are doing all these things, declares the Lord, I spoke to you again, but you didn't listen. I called you, but you didn't answer. Therefore, what I did to Shiloh, I will now do to the house that bears my name, the temple you trust in, the place I gave to you and your fathers. I will thrust you from my presence, just as I did all your brothers, the people of Ephraim. So do not pray for this people, nor offer any plea or petitions for them. Do not plead with me, for I will not listen to you. Do you not see what they are doing in the towns of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem? The children gather wood, the fathers light the fire, and the women knead the dough and make cakes of bread for the Queen of Heaven. They pour out drink offerings to other gods to provoke me to anger. But am I the only one they are provoking? Declares the Lord. Are they not rather harming themselves in their own shame? Therefore, this is what the Sovereign Lord says. My anger and my wrath will be poured out on this place, on man and beast, on tree and field, on fruits of the ground, and it will burn and not be quenched. This is what the Lord Almighty, the God of Israel, says. Go ahead, add your burnt offerings to your other sacrifices, and eat the meat yourselves. For when I brought your forefathers out of Egypt and spoke to them, I did not just give them commands about burnt offerings and sacrifices, but I gave them this command. Obey me, and I will be your God, and you will be my people. Walk in all the ways I command you, that you may go well with you. But they did not listen or pay attention. Instead, they followed the stubborn inclinations of their evil hearts. They went backwards and not forwards. From the time your forefathers left Egypt until now, day after day, again and again, I sent you my servants, the prophets. But they didn't listen to me or pay attention. They were stiff-necked and did more evil than their forefathers. When you tell them all this, they will not listen to you. When you call to them, they will not answer. Therefore, says the Lord, say this to them. This is the nation that has not obeyed the God, the Lord its God, or responded to correction. Truth has perished. It has vanished from their lips. Cut off your hair and throw it away. Take up a lament on the barren heights, for the Lord has rejected and abandoned the generation that is under his wrath. The people of Judah have done evil in my eyes, declares the Lord. They have set their detestable idols in the house that bears my name and have defiled it. They have built the high places of Topheth in the valley of Ben-Hinnom to burn their sons and daughters in the fire. Something I did not command, nor did it enter my mind. So beware, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when people will no longer call it Topheth or the valley of Ben-Hinnom, but the valley of slaughter, for they will bury the dead in Topheth until there is no more room. Then the carcasses of this people will become food for the birds of the air and the beasts of the earth, and there will be no one to frighten them away. I'll bring an end to the sounds of joy and gladness, and to the voices of bride and bridegrooms in the towns of Judah, and the streets of Jerusalem, for the land will become desolate. Here ends our first reading. Our second reading comes from Ezekiel chapter 36. Son of man, prophesy to the mountains of Israel and say, O mountains of Israel, hear the word of the Lord. This is what the Sovereign Lord says. The enemy said of you, Aha! The ancient heights have become our possession. Therefore prophesy and say, This is what the Sovereign Lord says. Because they ravaged and hounded you from the every side, so that you became the possession of the rest of the nations, and the object of people's malicious talk and slander. Therefore, O mountains of Israel, hear the words of the Sovereign Lord. This is what the Sovereign Lord says to the mountains and hills, to the ravines and valleys, to the desolate ruins and the desert towns that have been plundered and ridiculed by the rest of the nations around you. This is what the Sovereign Lord says. In my burning zeal, I have spoken against the rest of the nations and against all Edom. For with glee and with malice in their heart, they made my land their possession so that they might plunder its pasture lands. Therefore prophesy concerning the land of Israel, and say to the mountains and hills, to the ravines and valleys, This is what the Sovereign Lord says. I speak in my jealous wrath, because you have suffered the scorn of the nations. Therefore this is what the Sovereign Lord says. I swear with uplifted hands that the nations around you will also suffer scorn. But you, O mountains of Israel, will produce branches and fruit for my people Israel, for they will soon come home. I am concerned for you, and will look on you as favor. You will be plowed and sown, and I will multiply the number of people upon you, even the whole house of Israel. The towns will be inhabited, and the ruins rebuilt. I will increase the number of men and animals upon you, and they will be fruitful and become numerous. I will settle people on you, as in the past, and will make you prosper more than before. Then you will know that I am the Lord. I'll cause people, my people Israel, to walk upon you. They will possess you, and you will be their inheritance. You will never again deprive them of their children. This is what the Sovereign Lord says. Because people say to you, you devour men and deprive your nations of its children. Therefore, you will no longer devour men or make your nations childless, declares the Sovereign Lord. No longer will I make you hear the taunts of the nations, and no longer will you suffer the scorn of the peoples or cause your nation to fall, declares the Sovereign Lord. Again, the word of the Lord came to me. Son of man, when the people of Israel were living in their own land, they defiled it by their conduct and their actions. Their conduct was like a woman's monthly uncleanliness in my sight. So I poured out my wrath on them because they had shed blood in the land, because they had defiled it with their idols. I dispersed them amongst the nations, and they were scattered through the countries. I judged them according to their conduct and their actions. And wherever they went among the nations that profaned my holy name, for it was said of them, these are the Lord's people, and yet they have to leave his holy land. I have concern for my holy name, which the house of Israel profaned amongst the nations where they had gone. Therefore, say to the house of the Lord, this is what the Sovereign Lord says, it is not for your sake, O house of Israel, that I am going to do these things, but for the sake of my holy name, which you have profaned among the nations where you have gone. I will show the holiness of my great name, which has been profaned amongst the nations, the name you have profaned among them. Then the nations will know that I am the Lord, declares the Sovereign Lord, when I show myself holy through you before their eyes. For I will take you out of the nations. I will gather you from all the countries and bring you back into your own land. I will sprinkle clean water on you, and you will be clean. I will cleanse you from all your impurities and from all your idols. I will give you a new heart and put a new spirit in you. I will remove from you your heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. And I will put my spirit in you and move you to follow my decrees and be careful to keep my laws. You will live in the land I gave your forefathers. You will be my people, and I will be your God. I will save you from all your uncleanliness. I will call for the grain and make it plentiful, and will not bring famine upon you. I will increase the fruit of the trees and the crops of the fields, so that you will no longer suffer disgrace amongst the nations because of famine. Then you will remember your evil ways and the wicked deeds, and you will loathe yourself for your sins and detestable practices. I want you to know that I am not doing this for your sake, declares the Sovereign Lord. Be ashamed and disgraced for your conduct, O house of Israel. This is what the Sovereign Lord says. On the day I cleanse you from all your sins, I will resettle your towns and ruins will be rebuilt. The desolate land will be cultivating instead of lying desolate in the sight of all who pass through it. They will say, this land that was laid waste has become like the Garden of Eden. The cities that were lying in ruin, desolate and destroyed, are now fortified and inhabited. Then the nations around you that remain will know that I, the Lord, have built for what is destroyed and have replanted what was desolate. I, the Lord, have spoken, and I will do it. This is what the Sovereign Lord says. Once again, I will yield to the pleas of the house of Israel and do this for them. I will make your people as numerous as sheep, as numerous as the flocks for offerings at Jerusalem during her appointed feasts. So will the ruined cities be filled with flocks of people. Then they will know that I am the Lord. Here ends our second reading. And our last reading comes from chapter 14, verses 29 to 32. A patient man has great understanding, but a quick-tempered man displays folly. A heart at peace gives life to the body, but envy rots the bones. He who oppresses the poor shows contempt for their maker, but whoever is kind to the needy honors God. When calamity comes, the wicked are brought down. But even in death, the righteous have a refuge. Here ends our third reading. I think this is important. Solomon speaks to the heart of matters when he talks about having great understanding and not being quick-tempered. I know I myself have at times been very quick-tempered, and it's often not done me well. And that when we don't harbor envy, when we don't long for things that aren't ours, we begin to give more life to our own body. When we show kindness, we all honor God. And when we do things that are right before God with a heart of peace, we find that refuge that is in store for those who follow in the ways of God. But then there's the warnings that God gives against Jerusalem and Ezekiel, against the church, and how the church has done abominable, horrific things like sacrificing their own children to the other gods, doing detestable things in God's house. There's a lot of things. He shows them Shiloh, which used to be a temple and now is laid waste because they've neglected the things of God. But still in his disgust for the people's actions, God still gives them a promise and a hope. He says, I will change your hearts of stone to hearts of flesh. I will change you away from being the wayward son, the disobedient daughter, and I will bring you back to me. I will help to bring you a home once again, a place of worship, and I will be your God and you will be my people. And so these words of God are great words of hope, the return of his people, that God always is looking to change, transform people away from their wicked deeds in order that they might have life. And like Proverbs says, give life to their body. Yeah, because we don't want to harbor envy for other things we don't have. But when we have God, we have all we need. So we thank God for this. We just thank God and we lift up his praise through prayer. Let us pray. Father in heaven, we give you praise. We give you glory. We thank you so much for each and every word that you've given us each and every day. We thank you for your faithfulness. In Jeremiah, you highlight how your people failed to take care of the needy, the poor, the orphan, those who are without fathers, without mothers. Here in the book of Proverbs, you also note that those who oppress a poor man insult our maker, and then we insult you. May we be kind to the needy. May we honor you, O God. May those who are blind amongst us, those who are deaf to the cries of poor, may we take time to see and note and act in your ways. Help us to not be false children, but help us to be children that look to the needs of you, O God, the needs of your people in thought and speech and in action. Help us to be images in your world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for joining me again today for day 230. May you be a blessing as you go through this Bible and learn about God. May you act in his ways and shine his glory through you to the world in order that they might see your good deeds and worship your Father in heaven. Thanks be to God. Amen.